Into the mic. Thank you, sir. Let's all pray together. Heavenly Father, we humble ourselves before you, and we believe, Lord, that you are the answer for all the problems that we're facing, that we can put our hope in you through Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
And have hope again. Our faith can be built up again. That you can return to us the joy that is only from you. However, today, Lord, we lift up the man that we believe you've put your hand upon to help restore America and bring America back to the place that honors you. To a place where we will not be kicked out for saying Christ the King.
Amen.
Or Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
Lord, we want all faiths to be respected.
Yes.
All faiths. And we thank you that this is a man that does in fact respect all people of faith. So we ask, Lord, you would strengthen him, that you'd send your holy and warrior angels around him like we've seen evidenced already. But you'd continue, Lord, because we know that the blood of Jesus draws us near you. So we ask for that covering over him, that he would continue to hear your voice, that you would continue to order his steps, and that he would help us to make America godly again.
Amen.
I pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Apostle, let Apostle get in here.
Yeah. As I was talking yesterday to the in North Carolina, I mentioned to people the fact that this is not a war between the left and the right. This is a war between good and evil. So we can't combat that. We can't fight that in the natural. We need spiritual weapons to fight it. So prayer is one of them. And I believe President Trump is here because there's a purpose, there's a higher assignment for him to finish with this nation. So we're going to pray. Prayer. The Bible says that let's pray for the will of God to come.
Yes.
Meaning, what's the will of God? The Bible says God sets up kings. He removes kings. We're going to pray for the will of God for him to be the next 47th president. Do you believe that? I want you to stretch your hands toward him. In the Old Testament, the prophets anointed the kings to become kings. So today we're going to do what the Bible says. We're going to bring the will of God, and we're going to pray for the president, for President Trump to be the next president. So I want you to stretch your hand, and I want you to pray whatever you want to pray out loud. But let's pray with all the heart. Father, we thank you. We come to you and we lift up President Trump. Father, you protected him. You guarded him with a purpose for this time, such a time as this. And we pray today, Father, as an apostle in this country, as a man of God in this country, I pray for the kingdom of God to come, for the will of God to come, and for you to establish your will upon his life. And Father, we anointed him today. We anointed him to be the next 47th president of the United States, to restore the biblical values. Father, and I thank you today. You protected him. No weapon formed against him shall prosper. And he will go to the White House, Father, to represent you and to do your will in your assignment. I pray today that your will be done, and we'll be celebrating that you have put him as the next president. We give you the praise for your protection, and we pray for his family. We pray for every member of his family. You protected him, God, and to you be the glory. And today we can declare freely, Father, freely, Jesus is Lord over his life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Mr. President.